These are three rock samples and then three soil samples that came back from the Apollo missions. And I'm not sure how many of these discs there are, but they only brought back about 900 pounds of rock. So it's kind of cool. Now, if you, NASA lends these out to really teachers or educational institutions, libraries, whatever, who want to use them as to show them, and but you have to be certified.
Our having the samples here is to celebrate, you know, NASA's 50th anniversary and the 40th anniversary of the Apollo landing on the moon.
I think it's
great. I think it's, you know, I mean, it's really neat to see something that, you know, is from the moon. I mean, the samples are small, but they're nevertheless, you know, I mean, it is a part of another celestial body, and the whole idea of having that here is, I think it's
really great.
They
basically just want the public to see them, and but they are considered national treasures, so they want to limit the number of people that do handle them. So, I mean, I can't just, like, you know, let kids
wander
around.
Them out.
No, and I actually am responsible for these national treasures for the next 2 weeks. You can't go to Walmart and buy more lunar rocks, you know. It's like, this is it. Unless we go back to the moon. I mean, you get to see something from another planet. Really, this is very cool.